What is good, YouTube? It's your boy Metro back with another video, and today we're gonna be switching it up. Today we're gonna be doing a movie review on the movie Black Widow. Going into the movie, honestly, I didn't have many high expectations for it because, as many fans know, this movie should have came out way before then, and just seeing this movie solidifies what I was thinking about before. So going into the movie, you see, I'm not going to say too much because this is a spoiler-free review. Going into the movie, I'm going to just say the basics. It starts off as what happens after Civil War. And it goes straight into what would happen in Infinity War. That's as extensive as what I'm going to tell you guys. And she goes to meet her family, and a whole lot of things happen in between, and she meets her family and everything. And honestly, when she meets her sister, it's pure great acting. I'm not gonna hold you, the sister is a great actor, and she fit really well with Scarlett Johansson's character, and just basically saying how serious she was a lot of the time. And in this movie, the basic plot is about, like, how the Black Widows are being manipulated and how it's going to be a future of Black Widows and, like, an army of Black Widows. That I'm not going to tell you, like, details and stuff like that too much, but you see the movie, and honestly, I liked it. You know what I'm saying? Going into it, I didn't have high expectations, but I like the action. I like the high sequence of, like, driving, you know what I'm saying? The acting and all of it in general. I like the movie. I just wish it came out sooner. So, along down in the movie, they start to find out more darker things about Natasha Romanoff that they didn't know. And that starts to affect her throughout the movie. And also, the villain is this big time like boss or whatever, and he's in charge of the whole Black Widow organization. And the secondary villain is my favorite villain, Taskmaster. So Taskmaster has the ability to copy anybody in their fighting skills at any time. You know what I'm saying? He could see you do something once, see something done on TV, and he can mimic it perfectly. So that's what a lot of people don't know, that he's like top five best fighters in Marvel. So I don't know. Every scene that he was in was just amazing. Like, it was just one of like the best fight scenes I've seen in Marvel. And that's talking about Captain America Winter Soldier. Fire. But nearing the end of the movie, they start sewing up a whole lot of things, like start answering a lot of questions. What happened to Romanoff before this, you know, and what's going to carry on afterwards. And I feel like they should have did something different. They should have made this movie way more sooner, you know. And as a fan of the comic books and the fan of the movies, I feel like they should have took that into account instead of making Captain Marvel. So I would say I recommend watching the movie, but at the same time, my fan heart is saying that they should have came out with this way, way sooner. So out of my review and when I watched it, I've seen this movie twice already. I would say that I give this movie a solid 8.76, if that makes sense. Yeah, 8.76, because it's a great movie in general. And if it was just a standalone movie, then it would be like a 9.5. But this movie was great in its own end, but there was a whole lot of flaws with it as well, especially the predecessors, the movies before it. I think that's what made it worse. But seeing this movie, I have to give it an 8.76, I think I said. Yeah. So this was something different for me. I'm going to start doing this more often. Make sure y'all like, subscribe, comment to the channel, hit that notification bell so you know whenever I drop a video. So make sure y'all like it. Like I said, subscribe, comment. It's your boy Metro. This is a work in progress.